turn to your facilities tab. We have a breakdown on your SPLOST 7 projects. This is similar to what you've received each year. And I think we're going to start on page 3.
We'll look at page 3, yes, sir, and then we'll go from there. On page 3, you'll see, as you have in the previous retreats, all the projects and their status of hiring an architect or a bid date. And then we'll, starting on the next page, go through each one individually. If you have any questions, I'll be glad to answer them. The NATO boat ramp, we did start on that January 29th. The construction crew, Public Works, that we're doing the work. We started clearing and grubbing. We've got it pretty much all cleared up, the parking area and some of the driveway, and the silt fence is installed. The river is a little too high for us to start grading right now. I met with DNR Friday, was a week ago. We're keeping an eye on that. As soon as it hits that level where we need it, we're going to jump right in with the crew. We've got the equipment down there, knock it out. We're finishing up a project right now. They're close to the office. As soon as that's done, we'll start improving the driveway there as well. So the rock has been ordered. It will be delivered within the next few weeks. One truck at a time. The big rock, one ton rock.
Now, are you going to pour that in the river?
No, sir. We'll grade it out. We'll do our rough grading. And what we do is we take the rock. What we'll have to do is we'll take the rock, grade it out into the river, one bucket at a time, push it out. We'll create our grade. We'll pour the slab up on that dirt grade. Then we take two bulldozers and push it about 1 inch at a time, each side. Get two of them next to it.
And it rides up on that rock.
Rides on the rock. Just slide right down.
And you have to pour the edge of it at a chamfer so it don't dig. It'll ride and not dig into the rock.
Something you want to go watch, huh?
Yeah. Any more questions on that?
No, I'm just, I know a lot of folks, this has been that's been promised for quite a while. Sure. And I know that everybody's been working on it. I know that initially it was just so far out of budget that we didn't really think that we would actually be able to get to it. But I appreciate, again, your efforts in working, trying to come up with some alternative ways of Public Works efforts to be able to do it in-house. Because it is important to those folks over there. Yeah. So we need to, I'm glad to see that it's getting close.
It's going to be a nice area, and that property now is also a wildlife management area around the actual boat ramp.
The rest of it.
Dr. Acree put it into their volunteer program for WMA.
So I can see
my
comments.
Is that causing a problem?
I don't believe it would, not that I'm aware of. Freedom Park basketball court, of course, that's been done a few years now, and that's been getting positive responses from VLPRA all around.
I just wish we did more than one. I'll be honest with you, I've watched it occasionally, and it's packed on the weekends, and it was real nice.
It is.
Well, again, that was another one of those projects that come in way over budget as well.
Well, we did come in over budget. We knocked it back and knocked a few things off, but we didn't have enough to build two for sure.
That's right.
But I know it is used quite often.
It's used a lot.
The Civic Center, of course, that project has been complete. Been getting a lot of good responses from that project. Everything turned out really nice. And still looks good.
Thank you. Yeah. Nice.
Taylor Community Center, that project is complete. Our timeframe was April of 2018, so the contractor completed it actually January 27th, a little ahead of time. VOPRA is currently in the process of getting, finishing, hooking up all the fire alarm systems, all the, they're getting the tables and chairs, they're on the way, and that will happen in the next few weeks to be fully completed where it's a usable space.
And we'll pay ready.
Because we just asked, I guess by Mr. Riley, is it a daughter or granddaughter that's graduating from college or something? We'll have something there.
Nick took you there.
Oh, yes.
Okay.
Yeah. I expect, we're hoping, our goal was by the end of this month. We've ordered the tables, the chairs. As soon as AT&T gets their last line hooked up to the fire alarm, we can get our CO. So then we can allow people in.
So you're saying that it's hung up in inspections?
No. Indirect.
Waiting on to see.
Indirect. That's right. But it did turn out a really nice project. It looks really good.
Yeah, it does. Miss Evans and I had an opportunity to ride over there here about 3 or 4 weeks ago. I took a look at it.
The next project was the animal shelter renovations. We talked about last year, there were some concerns. We had a structural engineer come in and do a structural study. He did provide some leeway as to what the building can handle. There was a lot of structural work that needs to be done if we fully renovate the existing building. Will not, and he also explained that to keep it a further use for that facility, there would be a lot more work involved in what we currently do to maintain that occupancy. Just because of the settling soils under it, the material that was used to construct the building, it's diminishing quite a bit.
Old, is it?
It's not that old. It's a little over 20 years old. So.
That, you remember that Hagel product that was being produced up in Cook County? That was the product that was used. And it has shown that it's certainly in the environment that it's in right there is not the best use for it because it's, and again, causing some soil issues. But it's settling, it's cracking. I mean, there's literally holes in the wall where rodents have in the past have found a way to get in. I mean, it's a soft, porous type material, and it's in a harsh environment for that time.
And the way this material was sold and marketed, it is the structural base of the walls. They are, in other words, they are the structure of the building. And the way they're poured, you know, they're load-bearing walls. And those load-bearing walls are starting to
that supporting the roof.
So we have a reduction in the amount of dollars out there now, and between staying and moving and what have you. Do you think that $800,000 can build some facility that might be just a cage or a big building with space and then use that where they're at now is just admin?
No, I did it based on.
Just a cage? He didn't build a big cage.
The department
of
the
bag is a lot of money. That's
the
all I'm saying.
The department of the bag won't let us make it that simple.
That's right. Based on USDA regulations and department of bag. What we started, Mr. Pritchard, we've been talking about it for a while now, different options. And we're meeting with a couple local contractors to get some actual numbers of what it would take to, one, to renovate that existing facility the way the structural engineer has asked us to, if we did, that wasn't his full recommendation. And option two was to just partially go in there and do some cosmetic work and then go ahead and do a design for a new facility and possibly build out in two phases, where one phase of that is built in this $800,000, whether it be the back for the animal shelter or the front as admin. And then a phase two at a later date be the other section of the building. That way we have...
And the reason I say the cage, because I pictured when we did walk through, each animal was in a little 2x2 or something. Long story short, mm-hmm. You know, I know $800,000 can go through the building. I'm not saying we're going to make a crack house or nothing. I'm just saying, I know how much it takes to make a frame warehouse. I guess what I'm getting at.
Right.
With a slab, I know how much it takes for that, but I just didn't know.
Well, I think what we said earlier, Commissioner, is that now there's a lot more oversight and regulations that goes into a traditional, call it a dog pound if you want to, but it's an animal shelter. USDA, all of those folks now says that you should, the type of environment that you're supposed to provide for those animals that's currently in your care, whatever that situation is. So it's going to require certain qualities, certain amenities, and certainly keep in mind, there's one thing that I think that Mr. Pritchard and his staff has always been really, really good about, is that it's not something also, if we're going to do this, which we're going to do, it's something we've got to address. You don't build it for what your needs are today. You have to take in consideration, hopefully, what your needs are 20, 25, 30 years down the road. And so you have to build a type of construction that's going to last, plus you need the capacity as well. But certainly some of these programs that's out there, if we can continue to get folks to embrace spay and neuter, we can possibly reduce the population. But there, as we've seen, there's some out there in the population that's not going to buy into that, and we're going to continue to have animals that are going to continue to breed, and they're going to continue to become strays that's going to have to be dealt with. And it's just part of what we live in. We can't live in a society where we've just got strays running everywhere. They have to be, we'll have to pick them up. They'll have to be, do everything that we can to get them adopted out and get them rescued. And then outside of that, then the other options that are left is something we'll have to consider.
Okay.
It's a bigger picture.
And there's a lot, and there, when you build a new facility, there is a lot of entities that go other than just the building. Can we build a building? Yes. But everything we need inside that building, there's a good bit of cost involved in that as well. Because a lot of our existing, where the animals live, cannot be reused in the new facility.
Part of what we're trying to do with this facility is to make sure it is much easier and more cost effective to maintain it. We don't want it to be labor intensive as far as going in and cleaning the facility out, but we also want to make sure that it is humane for the animals as far as their climate, etc.
And we don't want the facility in 20 years to look like our current facility. And that environment, we have to build it so it doesn't.
It actually sticks our toes down the weeds there a little bit. Put the animals in there. I think we've already got some in there.
I'm offended by that, too. Now you're going to put our animals in jail.
Oh, excuse me.
Turn that off.
Go ahead. Library renovation. This is the library portion that is being renovated on Julia Drive, the old doctor's laboratory. That project is basically complete. There was some change orders to add some site work to that project. SC Barker is building that. We're a third party in with the library. It is looking to close it out by the end of this month based on the new site work they're going to do. What I've been told is they're looking at about a 2-month process to get moved in. With all the books they have, the furniture they have, the whole process.
I think they're going to start that in April.
I believe so. Yeah, it is a very nice project though. If you ever buy that way, you can stop in. tell him you're with the county, he'll let you in, the superintendent. And that's turned out very nice. Next project was the Lowndes County Sheriff's Office Evidence Storage Building. This was bought up by the previous sheriff, and the current sheriff has asked us not to proceed with the evidence storage facility that he can maintain with what he has. Of course, some of that money is earmarked on the referendum at jail facility. So some of that was used towards the washing machines that we purchased. And also some of it would go to completing the shower build out of Pod B, like we did on Pod A, which will allow him to move more inmates into Pod B. But he is making use of his current facilities for evidence storage. That he does not need a new one.
Okay, I want to ask something else though that could have a bearing on this, and it comes on further down. But even though with this building, we had also looked at, was there a possibility that we could do a evidence/record storage facility? And so we kind of looked to see if we could marry those two needs, because currently in the historic courthouse there's a lot of records there. We're going to eventually renovate that. We need to get all those records out, and they need to be stored in an environment. So I think that Mr. Pritchard and looking at what our other options are and the available options for those records storage. But at the end of the day, I guess you could say that there might be a need for a structure for those records to be stored.
Yes, sir. And that there is quite a few in that existing building, and then we have needs as well that come out of administration for record storage as well. There's actually roughly 8 rooms in the courthouse that we specifically built for record storage to handle that storage. It's all, they still use it on a weekly basis. They go over there, the clerk of court does, to make copies of old deed records or flats that are still stored there.
Has anyone talked to you recently about records there? I will bring this up here, and I know that to some degree you want to keep the hard copy of the record, but I have known that some groups, privately and publicly, are making an effort now to put all of those files on the data, I guess, through an IT process, and you're scanning them all in. I know I have a friend of mine that she's been working for one group, and that's all she's done for a year is just steadily scanning in all of their records so that they're saved electronically. My question would be, is that something that we might have to consider in the future if all these records could be safely stored in an electronic format?
With all that is, if we were to go to that type of system for retrieval purposes and all that, the software required to fully automate all of that, just the software before you started looking at hardware and someone's time to do it, would exceed $250,000.
I'm sure it would, but reality is then at that point, if you had something in place such as that, if the clerk of the court needed to pull a record, it's a simple search in her database to get that record, rather than going over to the courthouse or wherever the facility is and dig into boxes and boxes of records trying to find something. And much simpler, much quicker.
There are some things that legally you're still required to keep the hard copy on, but not many.
Yeah.
It used to be that there was a quarter of things that you could scan and trash the hard copies on. Now there's probably a quarter of things that's all you have to still keep the hard copies on.
I mean, we've got records that go back to the beginning.
But do you
a few.
Probably the part.
Well, I'm not talking about all the way back to Genesis now. I'm talking about the back.
So most of the.
About
yeah,
the Kira.
From 1825, when the county was established, that's the majority of our records start then with deeds. And then from there, it grows. You have to get into the late 1800s, around the time the historic courthouse was built, before we really got good criminal records from it.
All the earliest records were destroyed in the fire. Mm-hmm. And the last surviving document is like 1848.
But there's still a lot of records.
A lot of copies.
I agree with you though. That's just a conversation for another budget, probably.
The next project was Lowndes County Fire Rescue. There are several projects in fire and rescue. The main one, some of the main ones were a build out of the existing drill field, which is a drafting pit in the road. Staff is currently, we have the plans for the drafting pit. And basically what it is we go into the ground about 8 foot deep and build vertical concrete walls. And we have specific instruments on top of this tank in the ground, basically to be able to pump water out of the tank, pump it back into the tank. We've got all the requirements. We're actually pricing that out now to be built out. The warehouse built out, it's almost complete. I know y'all approved it not long ago, but contractor, he is currently got all the walls framed up, the painting is done, they're actually polishing the floors now. All that will be remaining is low voltage hookup and hooking up the new generator, or the existing generator, to the new part. We have completed the repair model at North Lowndes and at South Side, and we also have done some at Shiloh 2 on Webb Road. Our next ones will move to our west side neighbor and east side. And then we have some minor work to do here at Shiloh, here on Shiloh Road. We're going to rebuild a ceiling in there. It's not doing well right now. Next project was 911 expansion. That project is about 65% complete. They've got the new addition part. It'll be complete within 2 weeks. They've completed approximately 25-30% of the interior work, which they will focus on fully once they're complete with the new addition and turn that over to us. And then we're currently working right now to procure the new consoles that were made for room in the operations room. And we'll be bringing that to you before the commission for long. Courthouse renovation. That's the $2 million project we have. Staff is ready to move with this one now. We've got letters to go out to architects ready. Mr. Pritchard had talked and the chairman about putting a committee together to select the architect that we'd like to do the work, since it is such an historic renovation project. And it doesn't stop with this one project. This is going to be an ongoing relationship with whoever we choose to build this. And I know several have called me, and I know a lot of our architects in town, some of them have not done any historic work, some of them have. We've also had a lot of outside interest from some companies that's all they do is historic renovation work. So
we've also had some contractors that are from outside of the county but are within this area ask us specifically for the board to determine if they are eliminating architects that are outside. And just let them know if you're preferring to use local, then it will save them time and money from going in and making presentation and so forth for your consideration if they're not legitimately under consideration. So my proposal to you is that the chairman and Commissioner Ornstein, along with Chad and Mike, work to make this the presentation, the RFP, review those, and then make a recommendation back to the full vote. Y'all may want to throw that out and do something different. That's just my recommendation.
Suggestion.
In regards to design, we technically came up with what we wanted to be, or operate as, I guess.
That is in the next section. If you'll note, historic courthouse. There's two more items for Chad to go over, and then we'll move right into that.
Okay, the soccer complex. That actual bid date is March the 13th. The design is 100% complete. It's been advertising in the paper now for a little over 2 weeks. We've actually had a lot of interest in this project from all over. So there will be some good numbers coming in on this project, I believe. As far as the wetland permit, we have one half of the permit. We expect the other half to be completed before the end of this month. Again, this is a large project. It's 8 soccer fields, it's 516 parking places. We have 2 buildings. One building is a concession, restroom area, as well as changing rooms, and we're going to have a maintenance building. We've worked with DLGRA very closely to make sure they get what they need to operate and, you know, what's needed by the community as well.
Is this going to be at Freedom or at Hay Hiram?
This will be at Hay Hiram.
Rest area.
It's behind the rest area and to the north of the rest area.
The reason for us working so closely with Parks and Rec is because, as y'all know, Parks and Rec, as a park, they were created with the autonomy of their operation, and we can build something, a facility. But if they choose not to accept it or use it, they don't have to. So we've worked very closely with them to make sure that the design from the architect of Lowe's and Associates and the discussions with Chad, who is our intermediary with them, that everything is being put together, designed, so that it will be meet their standards and will be the type of project that we all will be proud of and will also have a long life expectancy.
I think also I would add this. The forethought that's gone into this is a big part of the LPRA's master plan and what they had planned to do. But this is going to be huge for Lowndes County as well. This, and I know very early on when we started talking about this, and it could have changed, but this was going to be one of the largest soccer complexes south of Macon. And so we're in a great location. As a lot of what DLRPA does, but of what they do is, I mean, they are as well an economic engine for this community. They bring a lot of folks in. They work extremely hard to bring tournaments into this community, which brings citizens and puts them in our hotels and motels, and buys food in our restaurants and those sort of things. So this soccer complex, I believe that when it's up and running, you're going to see a big impact on the Hay Hiram market area for services for those citizens and that's coming in again to this community. There'll be a lot of citizens using it here, but there's going to be a great potential for citizens coming into Lowndes County just to be able to utilize this facility?
I think Chad can speak to this better than I can, but in reviewing the type of product that Lowe's has produced in other places, I think you're going to be very, very pleased with this product. Those of you that have traveled over to Waycross, to that facility, Trembling Earth, Mike, you've been there, Chad, you've been there, I'm not sure if some of y'all have been over there. It is a very well organized, very well laid out facility. Lowe's and Associates experience goes from colleges and universities to larger community facilities, Gwinnett, Fulton, Cobb, and communities such as Statesboro, and of course the one in Ware County. So their reputation, I think, is without question, and the work that you will see, I believe, will be one that you will take a great deal of pride in being a part of.
I would agree 100%.
Miracle Field.
The Miracle Field, that project bids March 8th. Of course, the county has $150,000 going towards this project, which is a smaller portion of the overall project. There is actually four fields being built in the whole project, but all of our money is going towards the Miracle Field, which is a field for special needs children and adults. Asphaltic rubber field, and that's going to be built at Freedom Park. So that bids here in about 2 to 3 weeks on March 8th.
Before we go into the historical courthouse, any question on any of the projects that we've gone over so far? Anything y'all would like to know that Chad is the source of information?
How's your opinion?
You asked earlier about us building Chuck Dunman will be providing assistance, or will be actually
He will be doing the framing of the pour, and we will provide the materials. He will be providing the labor to actually pour it and push it.
And Public Works did the clearing.
They're doing everything else.
The ramp or the drive.
The driveway improvements. And we're going to do the rough grading and grading for that.
They've got the materials. As far as the historic